you sneaking off?
Just gonna make a cup of tea. My head hurts. And I got this really vivid dream last night that we did something really silly with a load of post-it notes.
Yeah. I wonder how Patrick's drive home was last night.
You don't think anyone saw us, do you?
No, I don't think so.
I drink like a teenage girl in the afternoons.
Oh, shut up, it was fun.
Not for Mum and Carm, it wasn't. I dumped my son on them.
You needed cheering up. I'm sure they'll understand it was just a one-off.
Oh, so it was a one-off, was it?
Well, no, I hope not.
I had a mad panic this morning thinking that I was late for work. And I realised it's okay because I don't have a job.
He didn't fire you.
Hey, not yet.
But he can't because you haven't done anything wrong.
Doug, I covered for a teacher that was having an affair with a student. I mean, what do you think my chances are in education now?
So how about lunch today?
Yeah.
Leanne's looking after the deli, and you can bring Matthew.
That sounds lovely.
Okay, good.
Where have you been, you filthy stop out?
Yeah, it's a long story.
Well, let's save it then.
I got suspended, Carm. And we went for a few beers, so.
Well, you've got a baby to look after now.
Thank you for your sympathy.
Sympathy? I've been trying to call you 5 times this morning, your phone's off.
Yeah, and I said I'm sorry, okay? I was drunk.
It's my fault, probably.
And what was he doing with you?
Drinking, mainly.
He's a parent now, so he needs to grow up.
Guys, that was Patrick. He wants me back at work in, like, 10 minutes, so I'm gonna have to go. Dinner tonight, though, yeah?
Yeah, sure, dinner's good. I'll cook.
Are you forgetting something?
Carl, please, just this once, okay? It's really important. I love you.
You can't go to school like that. You stink. You've got yesterday's clothes on. John Paul!
Oh, man. They must have been wasted. Why would anyone even do that?
Mate, just sick, didn't it? Ain't normal.
I meant the pathetic prank.
Mind you, I wouldn't have complained if it had been your mate Tilly and that teacher. See birds on the car bonnet.
Help me.
Ah, well, Roscoe. You made it in today. Well done.
Cheers, sir. Do I get a stick off of my chart? Best have my mum stop me wetting the bed, sir. Well, nearly. Work in progress.
Anything you would like to share with me this morning?
Esther, I know you were back.
Yeah, I'm not here for me. I'm here to see Mr. Blake. It's about Tilly Evans.
Your intentions with Miss Gilmore were honourable, I know that now. Although you did take loyalty to the extreme.
Oh, that's one way of looking at it. The other is that I was stupid enough to believe her.
Hmm. It has been said that I take things to extremes too. You know, all I'm asking is for honesty and integrity from my staff.
I couldn't agree more, Patrick.
You don't have any skeletons.
Need airing, do you?
No. Well, I don't really get out much anymore.
That's good for you. Now, before you start, there's a new student you want to keep an eye on. He's over there next to Callum Kane. His name's Robert Roscoe. And he's been excluded from his last 8 colleges.
Blimey. Well, I'm sure I can handle him.
Well, good to have you back. Though, perhaps you won't come in for teaching tomorrow, smelling of an old pub carpet.
Yeah. Do you think his mum will like that one for a family Christmas card?
Robert, hi, I'm Mr. McQueen. I'll be taking you for general studies today. You all right?
I think I've seen you around.
I don't remember your face.
No, I remember yours.
What's that supposed to mean?
No, nothing. You're just messing, isn't it?
Right, okay. Well, we'll have none of that in this classroom. You're here to learn. And if you don't like it, the doll queue's that way.
Nah, you're all right. Birds are fit, real.
Good luck with that one, sunshine. Right, ladies and gentlemen, if you'd like to take your seats, turn to page 17 in the textbook, and we'll get started. And seriously, Robert, if there's anything at all you don't understand or need to ask a question, I'm right here, okay?
And now, the tabloids on the phone about Miss Gilmore. You'd be surprised the whole college was subject to investigation, which could ruin my academy plans.
Oh, nothing we can do, just get on with the job, I suppose.
Yeah, easier said than done when you have students playing immature pranks on their principal. Don't ask.
Oh,
thought this place couldn't get any worse.
I thought I'd lost my job. Okay, and we'd had a lot to drink. I thought it was funny.
Funny?
I don't know what to say.
Maybe start by asking yourself why the hell you went into teaching if you wanted to behave like this. What you do in your private life doesn't interest me in the slightest, but you and Jen Gilmore made a mockery of us all.
No, that's not fair. You can't compare me to Jen Gilmore. We were just messing about. I mean, there's no harm done.
Only to your reputation, which clearly doesn't mean much to you. You are suspended again. With immediate effect.
What? You can't!
Not only have you shown a total lack of respect for me, but do you really think you can go back out there and have any authority? The students are all laughing at you.
Yeah, well, they'll be laughing even louder now, won't they?
Thank you for your support.
You missed one. Over here, sir.
Sorry, mate. Daddy messed up again.
Myra, taking £4 out, all right?
John Paul, Mr. McQueen, is he your English teacher?
Yeah. Why?
He's a good teacher, isn't he? You've heard what's happened. Some evil kids spreading his personal life all around school.
Yeah, I heard about that. It's disgusting.
I mean, what's that got to do with his ability to teach?
Kiss him, money, Mark.
You're too old to give your old mum a kiss now. You tell everyone what a good teacher my son is.
Yeah? Got a free period.
Did you see the photograph of John Paul Women from the deli? I feel so sorry for him. And Myra. He's the main breadwinner in that house. Look at her, poor love. She had them bills in that drawer for months. Honestly. You don't know nothing, do you?
What are you saying? Are you accusing me?
No, I just thought the gossip might have reached you, that's all.
He's squeaky clean now, boy.
That club. Been empty for a while, isn't it?
And?
It's a free bar. Come on, see what we can find.
No, I'm done for the day.
It's a victimless crime, mate.
Look, when I say I'm done for the day, I mean I'm done hanging around with a pathetic child.